G'day everybody, hello. My name's Andrew Sass. I'm here to do a gentle yoga class for inner peace in support of the Coronavirus World Support Group, Strong and Calm. So a little bit about me. I've been following Cindy Teevens for quite a while, a few years now, really enjoy her stuff. So I'm very happy to be able to share a yoga class with you guys today and support this group in that way. I started yoga myself 15 years ago. I've been doing it pretty regularly ever since. Started teacher training a couple years ago and teaching for over a year now. And just been really enjoying sharing the practice and actually ever expanding my own personal peace and personal awareness and compassion and gratitude. And I'm excited to share that with as many people as I can, which includes all of you today. So today the yoga class I said mentioned was a gentle yoga class, but there's something in it for everybody. If you're advanced or a beginner, follow along with the movements, then we're going to cultivate inner peace and inner awareness and a calmness that hopefully lasts with you. Some of it will last through the day, through the week, and hopefully something to last a little bit more timeless and forever. So I'm going to apologize up front for the setup. It's the best I can do given the equipment I have, and hopefully things start getting back to a little bit of a normal routine and we can start upping our game a little bit. So please leave comments to let me know if you're participating and how it's going, and we can make an assessment of putting more classes on, less classes on, I'm doing gentle once a week and a more level one class as well on Sundays. So let me know if you're participating and we can go from there. You can also send me any questions you have, if you have any, and so with that, it's a couple minutes till 3, so I'm going to wait till 3 o'clock, but before then, maybe we can all dedicate our practice. We're going to receive personal benefits from it, but what we'd like to do in the Dharma tradition is to offer your practice to somebody else, or another group who may be in greater need or suffering, and then you get your benefits and then you magnify those benefits and give them out to a larger group. So there's going to be, as I mentioned, since it's a gentle, there's going to be lots of time to practice the inner awareness. I'll give several cues throughout, but also I'm going to stay quiet at other times to allow you to develop that self-awareness and self-cueing so that you can practice this not just on the mat, but we like to say yoga off the mat, so you can always bring your mind back to the inner peace and inner awareness that we're developing here in our little mini retreats. So with that being said, it's just about 3 o'clock, so we can make our way to our mats and we'll start off in Shavasana. So we start our gentle yoga class in Shavasana. So this is lying on our backs. Our feet are about shoulder width apart. Our arms are out by our sides with the palms facing upwards. And then we just melt into the floor and try to relax our body. Again, let's see how relaxed we can get our body to be in the next few cycles of breath. And we'll try to, as well, relax our mind by focusing on the breath. So our mind can follow our body and our breath. And that's one way that we can bring it into the inner stillness and inner peace. So if we let the body rest in stillness, our mind will follow. So a couple minutes in Shavasana, and then we'll introduce some movements into the postures.
start to bring some movement into the body, and we're going to coordinate it with our breath. So we'll bring our feet together, bring our arms by our side, and as we inhale, we'll bring our right knee up in towards our chest. Wrap our fingers around our knee and start guiding it towards our shoulder, our right shoulder. Our left leg stays straight as if we're standing on the wall both beyond our feet below us. And then we become absolutely still in the pose. Keep following our breath. And as we exhale, we'll straighten our leg. And we'll inhale the left leg up and towards our chest, interlace our fingers around our knee, guide it towards our shoulder, and just become so still. Exhale, straighten our left leg, flat on the floor. Inhale, both our knees up towards our chest, our forehead up towards our knees, lifting our shoulders off the floor into a bit of a tight little ball. A very still ball. And exhale, straightening the legs, lowering our shoulders. And let us out a sigh. Then we'll bend our knees, place our feet about shoulder width apart, just below our hips. And we'll do some rolling bridges. So on the inhale, we tuck our tailbone and lift our hips up towards the ceiling. And exhale, we lower down. Inhale, we lift. Hips rising, reaching the top as we reach the top of our breath. And exhaling, lowering down. Our hips touching the floor at the bottom of our breath. A couple more. Inhale up. Exhale, we lower. One more on your own cycle of breathing. And then just relax the back, the thighs. Bring your feet together so that they're touching. Lower your knees to the right side. Maybe place the hand on the top of the leg. Keep that left shoulder on the ground. And feel a stretch throughout your side. And then just be absolutely still in the pose. Inhaling, we'll bring our knees up towards the center. Exhaling, we'll lower them down to the left. Right shoulder stays on the mat. And we enjoy the stretch. We'll inhale our knees up towards the center. And then you can just roll over to our right side. Take a few breaths in side rest pose. And then we'll continue on to our hands and knees. And we'll lower our hips back onto our feet. Place one of our cheeks onto the mat for a sleeping extended child stretch. Inhaling, we can come up onto all fours, place our hands underneath our shoulders, just our hips above our knees, make them about shoulder width apart, and we can tuck our toes. And we'll go through a series of cat-cows, so we can push our belly into our back, pushing all the air out of our lungs, rounding, lowering the head. For a cat, inhaling, pushing the belly down, the chest is forward. For our cow, exhale. For our cat,
hello, I'm back. I don't know how long that was paused for, so hopefully we finished the just a little warm-up sequence, and now where you can open the practice with a chant of three ohms. We can all come to the front of our mats if we're not already there. Our knees are slightly bent, our tailbone's tucked, our shoulders are above our hips, which are above our ankles. Lengthening it out of the top of the head, and we're bringing our focus inward into our breathing. And then we can open the practice with the chant of three ohms. If anybody notices the video interrupt, just shout out, let me know, and I'll restart it there for you. Alright. So we will warm up the body with a couple sun salutations. So Surya Namaskara. So standing tall, inhaling, we lift the arms up. Exhaling, we fold forward. Plant the hands on the floor. Bend the knees as much as you need to so the torso rest on the thighs, the head's lowering towards the floor. Inhale, the right foot all the way back. Stepping back, dropping the back knee down to the floor. The hips are low, the chest is coming forward for a low lunge. Then we're going to bring our left foot all the way back to meet it. For our plank pose, you can leave your knees down if to modify it, if that's where your body is asking for today. But we're trying to create a straight line from our heels, our hips, through our shoulders, extending out of the top of the head for one straight line. And then as we exhale, we can all drop our knees, bring our hips back a little bit so we can bring our chest to the floor and our chin for 8-point pose.
feeling a nice arch in the back. Maintaining that arch, we can push into our hands, bringing our chest forward for our cobra. And then rolling over the toes, lifting the hips up and back, bringing the chest towards the floor, shoulders are staying down for a downward facing dog. Inhaling your right foot forward, dropping the back knee, the hips go low, the chest is pushing forward for our low lunge. Our left foot comes forward to meet, forward fold, so the head is lowering towards the floor. Inhaling, we hinge up. And exhaling, hands to the heart. So that's the right side, so we'll continue on with the left side. Inhaling, the arms go up. Exhaling, fold forward. Left foot goes back, dropping the knee, the hips go low, the chest comes forward. And the right foot comes back. So for our plank pose, we'll all drop our knees, bring our chest, hips back, so we can bring our chest to the floor and our chin. Inhaling, we come through for our cobra. Hips go up and back, chest drops towards the floor. For a downward facing dog, left foot comes forward for a low lunge, drop the back knee, the hips are low, the chest is pulling forward, the shoulders are down, bringing the right foot forward for a forward fold. Inhaling to rise. And hands back to our hearts. And we'll do one more cycle, both right and left side, starting with the right side. Inhaling, arms up. Exhaling, folding forward. Plant the hands, right foot steps back, dropping the knee, the hips are low, low lunge. Left foot goes back for plank. Drop the knees, chest and chin for 8-point pose. Inhaling through for cobra. Exhaling, hips up and back for downward facing dog. Right foot comes forward, low lunge. Drop that back knee in, the hips are low. Left foot to meet the right, forward fold. Inhale to rise. And the hands to the heart. Inhale the arms up. And folding forward, plant the hands. Bring the left foot back, low lunge, hips are low, chest is forward. Right foot comes back for plank. Knees, chest and chin, 8-point pose. Coming through for cobra. Hips up and back, downward facing dog. Left foot steps forward, dropping the back knee, the hips are low, low lunge. Forward fold, so bringing the right foot up. Hinging at the hips to rise, and bringing our hands to our hearts. And then we'll bring our focus back to our breath. See if we're breathing
deeply, heavily. Bring our focus and awareness inwards. And see if our breath starts to stabilize and giving us a calming effect, calming our body and calming our mind. And then we'll move into some standing postures. So we'll start off with mountain pose. So bring your hands down by our sides. Your shoulders can go back and down. Knees are slightly bent. Tailbone is tucked. And we're lengthening up through our entire body, up through the top of the head, creating as much length as possible. And as we exhale, we can lower our chin towards our chest. We maybe will open or close our eyes. And then just stand supremely still, just like the mountain. And we can inhale, lifting our chin up, maybe opening up our eyes. And then we'll bring some movements into the posture. Again, timing it with our breath, or coordinating it with our breath for a count of six. So on a count of six, we'll lift both our arms, and about halfway through, we'll come up on our toes. So as we inhale, we raise our arms out to the side for one, two, three, flip the palms, four, rise up on the toes for five and six, the hands above our head. Exhaling, lower down for one, two, three, turning the palms, four, lowering the toes for five and six. One more time, but we're going to rest up at the top. So inhale, lifting the arms for one, two, three, turning the palms for four, up on the toes for five and six. And then make sure we have our awareness on our breathing and our breath. And this is what will bring us the strength and stability in the posture. As we exhale, we can just lower our heels down. We'll interlace our fingers, push the palms upwards towards the ceiling. Feeling a nice stretch. Make sure we can lift our toes. Make sure we have a slight bend in our knees and we're still tucking our tailbone so we can extend up. Shoulders are down, away from our ears. And then as we breathe in, we can tilt to the right. So extending through the side body on both the left and the right. Inhaling, coming up. Reaching the top of the movement as we reach the top of the breath. And then exhaling, just continuing on to the left side, reaching the maximum as we reach the maximum of the breath. And then back up. And just continue this movement for a couple more cycles following your own breathing. Done, we can come back to the center, leaving our arms up. And as we exhale, we'll bring our arms straight out in front, parallel to the ground, shoulders are down, checking our knees are bent, tailbone is tucked. Inhale. opening up through the body. Exhaling, we're twisting our shoulders to the right, our hips stay forward. Our gaze can stay out over our fingertips, and then we become absolutely still in our standing twist. As we exhale, we come back towards the center. Inhale to lengthen. And exhaling all the way to the left this time. Hips are forward, shoulders to the left, gaze out over the fingertips. Center. And we'll just step our feet a little bit wide for balance, just maybe underneath our shoulders. We're going to lean forward, place the left hand on the inside of the left leg, and then bring the right arm all the way up. Head is lowering towards the floor for a side, a twisting, standing bend. That left hand, bring it parallel to the ground along with the right. Kind of like an airplane, the chest is reaching towards the floor, flat back. And then we'll lower our right hand to our right leg, twisting to lift that left arm up, pulling up towards the sky. Or twist on the other side. We will step our feet wider so that the ankles are roughly below our wrists for our easy standing triangle. So again, slight bend in the knees, tucking the tailbone. Hands are pulling out, shoulders are down, and top of the head is pulling up. And we stand supremely still. And then as we exhale, we can lower our arms, bring our feet back together, bring our shoulders back, inhaling to lengthen up through the body, exhaling, we'll lower our chin to our chest for one more round of mountain pose. Inhaling, we can lift the chin. And exhaling, just releasing all the effort. Congratulating ourselves for surviving the standing postures and doing an excellent job so far. So we can then come onto our backs. And we're going to start working on some floor postures. So we'll bring our arms to our sides. We'll do corpse pose, which is very similar to mountain pose, but lying on our backs. So our feet are together. Our hand fingertips are pulling towards our feet. The top of the head is pulling towards the top of the room. And
and we focus on our breath. Place our hands flat on the floor, and then we're going to do leg lifts times and coordinate it with our breathing. So we'll start with the right leg. So as we inhale, we can raise the right leg for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, reaching the top as we hit the top of our breath and exhaling, then lowering for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, reaching the bottom at the bottom of our breath. One more time, right side, inhale. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale, we lower for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This time on the left side. So inhale, then lift the left leg for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale, we lower for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We inhale and lift for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Exhale, we lower for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We're going to lift both legs up now, for legs up the wall, so just release the effort in the body from the previous pose. Place the arms by the sides, palms facing down, maybe partly under the hips, and then we can push into the palms, lifting the hips, or lifting the feet up, so bending at the hips, till our legs are 90 degrees for legs up the wall. And then we just come absolutely still in the pose. And as we exhale, we can lower down. And then we're either going to repeat that pose, or move to the next progression, which we can raise our legs up, or the legs up the wall, or continue by placing a block underneath our hips, so raising our legs up the wall, support it, or moving into easy shoulder stand, which I'll demonstrate now. So we enter the same way, arms down by the side, palm facing down, bringing the legs to vertical, bringing the hands to the hips, tucking the elbows in, and then pushing our hips up over our shoulders or in that direction, bending our knees and keeping our feet as if they're flat on the ceiling. Easy shoulder stand. So again, wherever we find ourselves, we rest in the stillness of the pose, and by following the breath. And as if we're in easy shoulder stand, we can lower our feet towards the front of a room over our head for plow pose. Keeping your hands on your back, maybe straightening the legs. And if we're in plow pose, we can bend our knees to either side of our body, the balasana, then we can straighten our legs back out to halasana, placing our hands flat on the floor so we can slowly lower our hips to the floor. Under control, bring the feet all the way down. Bring the feet shoulder width apart, let them fall open wide towards the edge of the mat. Palms are facing upward for Shavasana. Release all effort and tension from the body. Into the next pose. So we'll do bridge pose. So we're going to hold bridge pose for a bit longer. So we'll bend our knees, placing them about shoulder width apart. We'll tuck our hips and on an inhale, tucking your tailbone, and on an inhale, we're going to raise our hips up towards the ceiling. Walk our shoulders in towards each other, maybe interlacing our fingers underneath the back. Maybe supporting our hips for supportive bridge with either our hands or our block. And then pushing into our thighs to give us a little more height and a little more movement towards the front of the room. Our bridge pose. As we exhale, we can release, lowering down. Straighten the legs and just release all the effort from the body, all the expectations from the mind. Come back to the breath. And we'll repeat that pose. Or move into the next progression. So everybody can bend their knees, place their feet about shoulder width apart, just below the hips. If you're moving into bridge pose, you can move into that now. Or if you want to move into easy shoulder stand, place your hands beside your ears so your elbows are pointing upward. And then everybody can tuck your tailbone. And on an inhale, but lift the hips up towards the ceiling, just like for a bridge. And if our hands are beside the ears, we push into the fingertips, placing the top of our head on the mat. If you have a deeper variation, you can go into that now. If not, wherever we are, we'll push into our thighs a little bit, bring our focus to the breathing, and just really bring peace, calmness and stability into the pose. And then we can push into our hands, tuck our chin towards our chest as we slowly lower down, straightening our legs. And sighing out all the effort from our bodies. And then rolling over to our right side, take a few breaths in side rest pose. And then we'll make our way all the way up to seated. We'll bring our feet out in front. And we'll do a Paschimottanasana, or a seated folding posture. So inhale, lengthening up through the spine, bringing our torso down on top of our legs. Bend our knees as much as we need to so that our torso rests on the legs. Let the arms relax, Let the body relax, let the legs relax. Let the head fall in towards the shins. And as we inhale, we can come up. And then just swing our feet around behind us so that we can come onto our bellies. And we'll do a couple back bends. So we'll do two cobras. The first one, we're going to bring our hands beside our hips. Our feet are together, pointed, pulling towards the back of the room. We'll push our bring some weight into the hands so we can peel our chest up off the floor. Pulling forward to extend our spine. If we'd like, we can bring our arms down to Sphinx and feel the nice stretch here. Or if we have more flexibility today, we can push into our arms for a cobra. All the while extending through the spine. As we exhale, we can lower down and just push into our hands, bring our hips back, our forehead to the ground for a few breaths in a child's pose. Inhaling, we'll come back up, all the way back to our bellies. So our feet are together, our hands underneath our shoulders. This time we're going to do an unsupported version of the cobra. So as we inhale, we're going to lift our, peel our chest up off the floor, pulling forward. And then we're going to lift our hands up off the floor. Working on building up strength and steadiness in our back and our core. As we exhale, lower down, pushing ourselves back into a child's pose, and just making sure we feel a really nice stretch and relaxation in the back. Bring our feet out in front for one last pose, a spinal twist. So our legs are straight. We'll bend our right knee, brace the left, that right foot on the outside of the left leg. Place the right hand on the floor behind our back. Then we can inhale, lengthening up, and exhaling, we'll twist to the right. And exhaling, we'll release. We'll switch legs. Left foot on the outside of the right leg, left hand to the floor behind the back. Inhaling, lengthening up. Exhaling, twisting to the left.
breathing. And then we can come on to our backs for final Shavasana. So we come, feet are about shoulder width apart, arms are at our sides, palms are facing up, and then we relax our body and just see how still and relaxed we can get our body to be. And we can do this by following our breath, which will also in turn relax our mind. So just follow the natural rhythm of your breathing for the next couple of minutes. By moving our fingers, wiggling our toes, gently rolling our wrists, our ankles, our shoulders, our hips, and then rolling over to the right side for a few breaths in side rest. And then we can make our way up into a comfortable seated position. And we'll close the practice with a chant. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti, which means peace, peace, peace. Shanti, shanti, shanti. So thank you for coming today and sharing your practice. I hope you have a wonderful rest of the day and enjoy the rest of the week and the weekend and beyond. So have a great time. Leave a comment. Tell me how it went, how you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.